Hey there, Dr. Joe McCullough here, best-selling author of Accelerated Learning Techniques for Students, and I'm excited to welcome you to this month's video blog. This month will be a continuation of the 10 Rules of Good Studying by Dr. Barbara Oakley from her best-selling book, A Mind for Numbers, How to Excel at Math and Science Even If You Flunked Algebra. Last month, I talked about the first 5 of her 10 Rules of Good Studying. If you haven't watched that video, please pause this video now, click on the link, and check that out, and then come on back. For those of you who have watched it, let's do a quick little recap of the first 5 of her 10 Rules of Good Studying. Rule number 1, use recall. Rule number 2, test yourself. Rule number 3, chunk your problems. Rule number 4, space your repetition. And rule number 5, alternate different problem-solving techniques during your practice. Well, let's take a look at the last 5 of her 10 Rules of Good Studying and how you can apply that to any math, science, or engineering class. Let's jump right to it. Rule number 6 of the 10 Rules of Good Studying is take breaks. Now, I love this rule because as a student, you can actually learn more and retain more information by taking more breaks. How can that be? Let me show you a quick little exercise I like to do during my fun shops and help to illustrate why taking more breaks can actually result in more comprehension and faster learning. Whenever I do an accelerated learning fun shop for either teachers or students, I always like to do a little memory exercise, and the exercise is as follows. I show participants the list of 20 words that you see on the screen, and I give them about 1 minute to memorize as many of those 20 words as possible. Then at the end of a minute, they take out a piece of paper and write down as many of those 20 words as they can remember. I've done this exercise many, many times, and the results are always about the same. The top 3 words that are remembered are table, which has to do with the fact that it sticks out from the others visually, and grass and pen. And the reason grass and pen are among the most well-remembered has to do with their order in the list. There's something called the primacy recency effect or the serial position effect. And it basically states that we tend to remember the most at the beginning or end of any list of words. And this doesn't only apply to memorizing a list of words, it also applies to any kind of learning in general. We tend to remember the most at the beginning and the end of any learning session. What this means as a student is that if you were to study, let's say, for just 2 solid hours straight, which I would not recommend, then you're going to remember the most at the beginning of that 2 hours, at the end of that 2 hours, and then in between, your comprehension is going to drop. Well, what this means is, rather than studying for, let's say, 1 long 2-hour session, I were to break it up into 2 or 3 mini sessions with a short break in between, then I have more beginnings and more endings, which means I'm going to remember more of what I'm learning. So one of the best things you can do as a student is don't study for extended periods of time without taking a break. I like to recommend 25 minutes on, 5 minutes off, 25 minutes on, 10 or 15 minutes off, and then repeat that cycle. What you're doing is you're giving yourself more beginnings and more endings and more opportunities to remember more of the information. Rule number 7 is use explanatory questioning and simple analogies. One of the things that makes someone an expert at any topic is understanding it at a deep enough level that they can explain it in simple, everyday language so that anybody can understand it. So as you're studying, think about this. How would I explain this material to a 10-year-old so they could really understand it? One of the best ways of doing that is using simple analogies, connecting the new information to something that they already know. So for example, whenever I teach conceptual physics and we study electricity, I always give the analogy of an electric circuit being similar to a water circuit. And the reason I do that is because everybody can picture the flow of water in a pipe, but not everybody can really picture the flow of electrons in a wire. And so by using a simple analogy, it makes it easier for people to really understand what's going on. So next time you're studying, think about how would I explain this to somebody who doesn't really have the math and science skills? What kind of analogies could I use? And don't just think about it, take the time, write it out, and explain it to somebody else. Rule number 8 of the 10 rules of good studying is focus. What this means is that when you sit down and do work, what you want to do is really focus on the task at hand and get rid of all external distractions. Facebook, gone. Email, gone. Silence your cell phone and focus intensely on the task at hand for 25 solid minutes and then give yourself a break. This is called the Pomodoro technique because they used to use a timer which looked somewhat like a tomato. Set that for 25 minutes, and Pomodoro is Italian for tomato. I used to teach my students to study in 45, 50-minute blocks followed by a 10-minute break, and I realized that 45 or 50 minutes of focused attention might be a lot for some people, and you may need to work up to it. So now what I like to recommend to my students is study for 25 solid focused minutes with no external distractions, take a quick little 5-minute break, and then do another 25-minute focused session, and then take a longer 10 or 15 minute break. The end result of this is in about an hour, hour and 5 minutes of work, you're gonna get a solid 50 minutes of focused attention. And you'll be amazed at just how productive you can be when you get rid of all external distractions and focus intensely for a short period of time. And as a student, if you can do 2 or 3 of these 1 hour bursts where you get 50 focused minutes done, you will be unbelievably productive. You will rock it as a student. Think about really setting yourself up for success. Get rid of all external distractions, get a timer, and focus intensely for 25 minutes, take a 5-minute break, another 25 minutes, and then take a longer 10 or 15-minute break. Do that a couple times a night, maybe 3 times a night, and you will be rocking it as a student. Good luck. Rule number 9, eat your frogs first. What does that mean? Well, a frog is just an analogy for the hardest thing that you need to do that day. And what you want to do is do the toughest things first while you're still fresh. Don't put them off until the end of the day when your energy is low, your focus might be fragmented. An analogy I like is, let's say for some reason you knew you had to eat a frog today. If you didn't eat that frog, for some reason, something terrible is going to happen. Well, the worst thing you can do is sit there and worry about it and procrastinate and think about how awful it's going to be and then finally eat the frog at the end of the day. You have to do it anyway. Why not do it right at the beginning of the day? Get it taken care of so you don't have to spend any mental energy thinking about it, worrying about it. So as a student, a great technique is to make a list of everything that you have to do that day, find out what the most important thing is, and do that right away. As soon as you get up, do the hardest thing first. Don't put it off until the end of the day. Do it right away before you check email, before you surf the web. Wake up and do your most important things at the beginning of the day when you're freshest, when you have the most energy. And that way you're not continuing to worry about it and think about it and using valuable mental energy. And on a related note, there's a great book by Brian Tracy that I highly recommend called Eat That Frog, 21 Great Ways to Stop Procrastinating and Get More Done in Less Time. Check it out, Eat That Frog by Brian Tracy. And last but not least, rule number 10 is make a mental contrast. What this means is you want to contrast where you started with where you want to go. Think about what is the end result of all of this hard work that you're doing. What is your dream? What do you want to accomplish? Is it go to medical school, become an engineer, land your dream job? Whatever it is, you really want to keep that focus, keep that picture in your mind because it'll help keep you motivated. Let me show you a quick little Simpsons video that I love that may help illustrate this point.
Most people don't know the difference between apple cider and apple juice, but I do. Now here's a little trick to help you remember. If it's clear and yellow, you've got juice there, fella. If it's tangy and brown, you're in cider town. Now, there's two exceptions and it gets kind of...
You can stay, but I'm leaving.
Candy yellow after using late season apples. And of course, in Canada, the whole thing's flip-flop.
Ah, valuable life lessons from The Simpsons. So what's the point of this video? The point is that we all have the same favorite radio station, whether you realize it or not. And that station is WIIFM. Okay, that's not a real radio station. It's an acronym, and it stands for What's In It For Me? An extremely valuable question to ask yourself, especially as a student. And the reason is our brains don't tend to care about things that we don't see as personally relevant to us. If you cannot see the personal benefit behind why you're taking a class, you are not going to be motivated to study and put in the required effort to do well. So ask yourself, what's in it for me? Try and see the big picture. Remember the mental contrast between where you started and where you want to end up. What is the end result of all of your hard work? Is it to get into graduate school, land your dream job, become a doctor? Whatever it is, keep that big picture in mind. Think about what is the end result of all of your hard work. Remember, what's in it for me? If you can't answer that question, you're not going to be motivated to put in the work. Well, that's it for Dr. Barbara Oakley's 10 Rules of Good Studying from her best-selling book, A Mind for Numbers. I hope you enjoyed this month's video blog. If so, please like us below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you stay informed of future videos. Thanks, and happy learning.